Hello everyone. So for today's video, I'm very excited to be sharing my DNA test results. I use MyHeritage. It's a DNA company that analyzes your DNA, compare it to that database to determine what part of the world or the ethnicity your DNA originates from. So taking this test, I did not expect anything crazy to come out of it. Obviously, I'm from Central Africa, so I did not expect Ukraine or Australia or anything crazy like that. But I did have a reason for taking this test. And to explain it, I would need to give you a little bit of background. So I'm Gabonese. More specifically, I belong to an ethnic group called the Fang, F-A-N-G. And we represent 40% of the population of Gabon. And I take so much pride in being part of that group. It's crazy because it's not something that I've achieved. I was just born into it. I love every part of being Fon. I love the culture, the tradition. We are well known for loving peanuts. We eat it dried, grilled, boiled, roasted, in cassava leaves, in bitter leaves. Anyways, we can eat it. It has a lot of protein, so it's good for your health. And I also love the dance. I love it because, first of all, it's beautiful. Second of all, I like the fact that it's different from the other dances, from the other ethnic groups, because we don't really move the hips and the waist, it's more in the shoulder, the shoulders and the footwork. So I feel like there's a little bit more swag to it. Unfortunately, I do not speak Fon, but I know I understand a few sentences here and there, like Mbolo, Wokeve, Akubefan, although I don't, Manurewa, Waduk, Tabosi. So there's that. So the Fon have tales and legends that say that we don't originate in Gabon. We would come from a place up north with the lakes and different vegetation and landscapes as what you would see in Gabon. And that led people to believe that we come from Egypt. Why Egypt? I don't know, but that's a story that's being told. And so I wanted to find out if there was any truth to that story. So that's the reason I took the DNA test. Therefore, without further ado, let's see the results. So I have 96.8% of my DNA coming from Africa, 51.3% being Nigerian, 3.8% being from Sierra Leone, and 3.7% coming from the general area of West Africa, I guess. And I have a third of my DNA that would come from Kenya, go Kenya, and 4.6% coming from Central Africa. So the thing with that geography is that what we call Central Africa, it's central if you look at the continent north to south, but it's really on the west coast. So I'm not surprised that most of my DNA comes from the general area of Central and West Africa. So for East Africa, the Kenya part, I guess it's nothing that the natural migration of people over the years wouldn't explain. So I'm not surprised by that either. Well, the surprising kind of part was the 2.4% from West Asia and 0.8% from Europe, from the Ashkenazi Jewish. I'm not sure, but I think that would be consistent with the previous part, West Asia. There was no Egypt, so I wonder though, the DNA that they have in their database for Egypt, does it represent the DNA of the population that was there a thousand and thousand years ago and that was most likely black? Or does it represent the DNA of the population that came after with the Muslim conquest of the north part of Africa? So there's that to consider, I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you believe in the validity of that kind of testing? What about my fun people watching? Do you still believe we come from Egypt? For me, it doesn't change anything to what or who I know that I am. I was wondering, I've got some answers, and now they have my DNA on fire. So I guess that's a wrap for me, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Oh, whoa, I'm not gonna lie, I'm a bit mad that I spent 70 bucks for them to tell me that I come from Western and Central Africa, but hey, that was still exciting. That was still fun to take.